Hey guys, welcome back. Today's video, I am finally going to be reviewing the Bye Bye Birdie collection from ColourPop Cosmetics. I know I am so late to review this collection. I think it came out almost 3 months ago. I know, I just feel like during that period when this did release, they were releasing something every single week. I was already falling behind all of my ColourPop reviews, so there were some things that I wanted to review before this that excited me a bit more. Yeah, we are here today, 3 months later, reviewing this collection. I know a couple of you guys have been asking me if I'm going to be reviewing this and you guys were waiting for it. I am so sorry, like truly. I am just one person with two eyeballs and I can only film so much and edit so quickly with all these launches coming my way. I don't have the whole collection, however, it was a kind of big collection. I got the palette, I got three of the lip products, I got the eyeliner, the mascara, and the three lashes. You guys know the drill. I'll be sharing my thoughts on the collection, giving you guys some swatches, comparisons, and three looks, so it's going to be a long video. So grab a snack and let's just go ahead and get started. So because this collection is kind of big, I'm just going to talk about each product individually and we'll just go from there. So the first product that I want to talk about is obviously the Bye Bye Birdie palette. This is always the most exciting thing to me personally. I'm always excited for new eyeshadow palettes. That's just my thing. So this palette is $18 and you do get all four formulas that ColourPop has to offer when it comes to eyeshadow. So you have your mattes, your metallics, your super shock, and the pressed glitters. So there are two pressed glitters in here, two super shocks in here. This is kind of like the overview of the palette. I think it's super pretty. I love pinks and purples on my eyes. I think it complements my eyes really well and it looks really good against my skin tone. I think other than like neutrals, I think pinks, purples are probably the next color family that I think suits me the best. So when I saw the palette, I was excited for it, but obviously not excited enough to play with it because it took me 3 months to get here and other palettes excited me more. But after playing around this palette, I really enjoyed it. I really like the looks that I created, although I do think the looks look, you know, fairly similar. The only thing that really changed was my technique. You're not really getting a variety of color story with my three looks. They all have that same like fuchsia underbase with all the eye looks. It's just a different technique. So you're not really getting too much of a variety of color stories in here, but I really do like the looks that I created. I think you get a good transition, good medium tones and good dark tones. And then you also have the beautiful metallics, glitters, and shimmers. Me personally, I don't mind the glitters because I've never had an issue with it. I'm also very careful when I do play with glitter, but I know for some of you guys it is an issue. I think not every single palette needs to have a glitter. I think it depends on the palette, but I think for this palette, I think the glitters actually do complement this palette and the eyeshadows in here. I think the super shock shadows in this palette as well was a great addition. I really enjoyed that. So just overall, I think it's a really great palette to work with. You guys will see my comparisons a little bit later on, but if I just had to give you like a general gist of this palette and kind of like compare it to a palette, not single shadows, I would say it's a combination of the Ooh La La, It's My Pleasure. It also gives me Sweet Nothings vibes and also She vibes. So if you like one of those four palettes, I think you would actually really enjoy this palette as well. Again, you will see my comparisons later on, but overall, it was a really great palette. It's not a palette that I will always pick up because it's not every day that I would wear pink eyeshadow, but when I do, I would think about this one. And I think a lot of the metallics in here are super beautiful. I think the super shock shadows really stand out to me as well. Other than the pressed glitters being a con for some of you guys, I think another con for me personally is I did have an issue with Heron Chic when I was building this color on top of another matte. It did come out very patchy and it skipped a lot. Maybe on this eye, I'm not sure on camera, you could kind of see it like skipping a little bit. I did try to put black eyeshadow on top of it so you couldn't really see the skipping, but I did have an issue with that, just layering on top of mattes. I do have it on my bottom lash line on its own, just right on top of my concealer and powder, and it went on fine. I think just layering on top of other eyeshadows, it created an issue of patchiness. But other than that, everything else, like, honestly worked fine, just like normal ColourPop eyeshadows. If you were looking for a fuchsia palette, I feel like fuchsia is a good mix of pinks and purples, then this is a really great palette to get. I just think at this point it is really hard for me to recommend palettes to you guys without it being like my top fave, because I have so many ColourPop palettes and palettes in general that even if I do recommend this to you guys might not see me, you know, use it as often. It doesn't mean I don't like it, it's just I have other palettes that I go to more that suit my day-to-day needs. But overall, to sum it up, I would recommend this palette to you guys. I think it is a really great fuchsia palette if you're looking for that. It's not a palette that I would pick up every day. It's not like my holy grail palette, but I really enjoyed it. And it's definitely a palette that I would pick up again. It's not like a palette that I'll never touch again. Yeah, if you're looking for a pop of fuchsia that you need in your palette collection, I think this is a really great one to go to. Also in this collection, there are two ultra glossy lips and they are $7 US each. I only picked up one and I got the shade Well Nested, and that is also the shade that I'm wearing on my lips right now. I really like this gloss. I think it's a beautiful shade. I feel like if you like the Aquarius gloss, you will really enjoy this gloss as well. It's like a darker version of Aquarius, but it kind of has that same undertone. It's more high shine. It's like a different formula from the Aquarius ultra glossy lip. So this one is a bit more high shine and it has little specks of gold glitters in it. It's not gritty or anything, but it does have the glitters and therefore that extra shimmer in your lips. So I really enjoyed this gloss. I really like the undertone of it. I am most likely going to be keeping this in my top drawer because I just think it's a really great everyday gloss. It gives you that my lips but better sort of vibe. I feel like it's been a while since I've recommended a gloss to you guys, so this might have to be one of my new favorites. There are also three ultra blotted lips in this collection as well. They are also $7 US each and I picked up 2 out of 3. So the two shades that I got is Tattletale and Cloud Chaser. So Tattletale on me is quite light. This shade on me, I personally wasn't a fan of it, but if you like the look of it, you like the ultra bottle lip formula, then why not? I think it's very affordable for the amount of product you're getting. We then have Cloud Chaser. Surprisingly, I didn't mind this one. If you guys have watched a couple of my videos, I have mentioned many times before that I don't like cool tones, but this one is definitely a cool tone lip color and I actually didn't mind how it looked on my lips. Maybe because it's like more of a darker mauve-y cool tone lip color that I could pull it off. I don't know, but I didn't mind it on my lips. I'm not gonna say it's like my favorite, it's not going on my top drawer, but it's one of those cool tone lip colors that I didn't mind against my skin tone, and that's very rare. So that's saying a lot. Out of the two that I got, if I had to recommend one, I would get Cloud Chaser, but honestly, you can skip on both. But it depends on you and your lip color preference. These are just not like my go-to lip color preference. We also have some extra eye products. So we have the creme gel liner in the shade Charmer, which is $5.50 USD. And there's also a matching gel pods liner, which is $6.50 USD, which I did not pick up. So I did pass on that, but some of you guys might know that I am trying to collect all of the creme gel liners. So for this one, I think it's a really great addition. I try to compare it to some other like dark purples that already exist in ColourPop, but this one's very different. This one is truly like a plum and I feel like it was missing a gap that ColourPop didn't have. When you do more darker pink purple looks, this eyeliner will come in handy, so I actually really like it. I've also said this many times before as well, but with the creme gel liners, some are good and some aren't. Some won't even show up in your waterline and some do, no matter how watery your eyes are. I would say this one's kind of like in between. It does show up in your eyes, but if your eyes are watery, it will rub off. So just keep that in mind. Nonetheless, I really enjoyed this eyeliner and I can see myself getting a lot of use out of this. We have a BFF mascara and this is $8 US. It is in the shade Plum and Get It. For colored mascaras, honestly, I don't really know why I gave this a chance. To be honest, my lashes are just so small. I just feel like maybe next time I'll just skip out on the BFF mascaras, because when it comes to colored mascaras, I really don't use them. There's just no purpose for me to use it because it doesn't even show up on my lashes. I think it looks nice on the lower lash line. I think if you had like long luscious lashes, then that will look really great on you. But because I have shoulder lashes, I personally can't recommend it. I don't see myself really using this, so I would have skipped out on this one. So now let's talk about the false lashes. A lot of you guys have been asking me my thoughts on the falsies because they did launch a really long time ago. I just didn't really talk about it in a video, but because these are like part of the collection, it's in the Bye Bye Birdie packaging, it's the perfect time to talk about it. And I did try all three styles out with the three looks. The lash that I'm wearing right now is called Baddie, and these are the most dramatic ones. By the way, these are $8 each, which is pretty affordable for lashes in my opinion. My go-to lashes are from House of Lashes, and those are $12, which I still find very affordable, but these are like $4 cheaper. So anyway, the style that I'm wearing right now is Baddie. These ones are the most dramatic ones, so they are a little bit more heavier, and they're actually heavy for me. And personally, like, I feel like I do wear a lot of dramatic lashes, but these are probably one of the most dramatic lashes that I have, and probably one of the most heavy lashes that I have. I can feel my eyes kind of like weighed down a little bit. Honestly, I do like how it looks. I probably wouldn't have worn it with a half cut crease, maybe like a smokey eye. That would have looked a bit better. Yeah, it's a little bit heavy. It's not my favorite band to work with, and it's also not like a holy grail style, but it's probably a style that I would wear again. We have Doll, which is pretty much long all around. It's very sparse and very like spread out. It's not condensed, it's not crossing over, it's just like long lashes all around. This is not my kind of lash style. I think it's a little bit too long for my personal liking. Something about the band on ColourPop lashes, some of them reflect a lot. And typically with lashes, when they do have that reflection, you can just use black eyeshadow or black eyeliner and go over it, and that shininess will go away. Some of the ColourPop lashes, it doesn't really do that. And especially with their first launch, when it came in the whatever packaging, I did not like those lashes. The way it was curled as well just didn't look well against my eyes. The shininess of the lashes, it just looks so fake. Like, obviously fake lashes will look fake, but they just look extra fake the first launch because they were just so shiny and you could not get rid of that shine. These ones are a little bit better, but I feel like Doll does have a bit of that shine that I couldn't get rid of. And Doll is just not a style that I typically would wear. I think for certain eye looks, I will get my use out of it, but it's definitely not a go-to either. We then have Shorty. So Shorty out of the three is probably my favorite one, surprisingly, because it is a much shorter lash lengthwise, and compared to House of Lashes, it's much shorter. This is probably like one of my shortest lashes that I have, but this one is like double layers, so they do crisscross a little bit more. This is more of a style that I enjoy against my eyes. I feel like these lashes will look really great on someone that has mono lids. You don't like a lash that is too long, because I feel like if you have mono lids, because you don't have so much lid space, you do need a shorter lash, or it's just going to touch your eyebrows, right? So I think Shorty is a great lash for Asian eyes or for mono lids. This is definitely more of like a natural lash, but more glamorous, if that makes any sense. So I enjoy Shorty. I can see myself using Shorty more often. It's not my go-to. It doesn't beat House of Lashes, but out of the three, this is a lash that I could recommend to you guys. So those were all the items that I picked up from the Bye Bye Birdie collection. There are a couple of other things in this collection that you can purchase, which I will quickly run through. So there are four Jelly Much eyeshadows, which are $8 each. There are two new designs of the Nail Art Decal, and then they also have two sets of the blush and light stick duos, and those are $14 each. So that was pretty much the entire collection, the little rundown. So now I want to give you guys my recommendations from the products that I did get to try from this collection. These are the products that I see myself using again and again in my day-to-day life. They're not necessarily holy grail products, but they're products that I would use again. So these are like my top recommendations if you did want to purchase something from this collection. But the first recommendation is the eyeshadow palette. I really enjoyed this palette. I think it's a really great palette. With the amount of mattes, you get the variety of metallic shadows, and I feel like the metallics in here are quite special, so I really enjoyed playing around with this. The Super Shock shadows as well really stand out to me, so I would recommend that. I would also recommend the Ultra Glossy Lip. I think out of everything, this is probably the product that I would use the most. It's just because I do wear glosses on a day-to-day basis, so it's just something that I would typically grab towards, and it's gonna go in my top drawer for sure. I would also recommend the creme gel liner in the shade Charmer. I think this would come super handy. I feel like just having a variety of eyeliners in your collection is super handy because it really does tie in a look, and I feel like I do create a lot of like purpley pink eye looks, so this plum eyeliner I know I'm just going to get a lot of use out of. And for my last recommendation, it would be the false lashes in the style Shorty. Actually, out of all of the false lashes that I have tried from ColourPop, this is probably my my favorite one. So I have 6 styles in total. This would have to be my favorite style from ColourPop so far. Those were my 4 recommendations. We can now move into the swatches, the comparisons, and then my 3 looks. Alright you guys, getting started with the first look. I'm going to be starting off with the shade Nesting, and this is going to be my transition shadow. I'm just going to work that straight into my crease using windshield wiping motions. This is a very light transition shadow, so it's going to be very easy to blend this out. And transition shadows are always important because it's going to be that soft blended base. I'm next moving into the shade Fly By Night, and I'm going to pack this onto my lid space. And once you have all of that packed on, you are going to bring it up towards the transition shadow and towards your crease area. I just want the most pigmentation on my lid. That's why we are focusing most of the product there first. And then once you have little product left on your brush, that's when you want to blend it up towards your transition shadow. I'm also going to take this shadow onto my lower lash line as well, right from the outer corner to the inner corner, really smoking this out. And as you can see, towards the outer corner, I am connecting these shadows. Now I am taking the shade Huron Chic, and I'm going to be doing exactly the same thing pretty much, but I am going to focus it a little bit lower than Fly By Night. Huron Chic is a little bit more vibrant, and it's really going to bring in that purple Bye Bye Birdie vibe. Pretty much just doing exactly the same thing, just packing that onto my lid space and then also bringing that onto my lower lash line as well. And then I'm going to take a mix of Nevermore and a bit of Gander. I'm going to place that right at the center of my eyes. Nevermore has more of that pinky golden tone, which will really complement the purple eyeshadows underneath it. But then I really like Gander because it is that super shock formula. It has those really pretty specks of glitters, and I think the combination of the two really gives a very pretty sparkly effect to the eyes. So I decided to just mix them together. But then I just took Gander on its own to highlight my inner corners as well as my brow bone. Taking the creme gel liner in the shade Charmer, I'm going to use this to tightline my entire bottom waterline. I also popped on the lashes that are from this collection in the style Doll. I then also took the BFF mascara in the shade Plum and Get It, and I used this on my bottom lashes. All Alright you guys, so this is the first look completed. For my final lip pairing, I went with the Ultra Blotted Lip in the shade Cloud Chaser. I think with this smoky halo eye, I thought this lip color would have been perfect because it just makes the whole look monochromatic. And you guys know me, when I can be monochromatic, I will take that opportunity to do so. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this first look. I really liked how it turned out. It's very glam, very smoky, just up my alley. So I hope you guys enjoyed this first look. Okay, second look. We are starting off with the shade Nesting once again. This is going to be our transition shadow. Just going to work that straight into our crease using windshield wiping motions. I personally feel like this is just the perfect transition shadow because it's not too light, it's not too dark against my skin tone, so it really works well as a really blended base. I'm next going into the shade Plumage and I'm going to work this at the outer corner of my eyes. This second look is going to be like my soft glam look, so it doesn't need to be too pigmented or too dark at the outer corner, but I do want a bit of depth at the outer corner. I'm also taking that onto my lower lash line as well. I'm first going to focus the product at the outer third once again and then bring what is ever left towards the inner third of my lower lash, and at the outer corners you are connecting those shadows together. I then took the shade On a Wing and I'm going to place that at the inner third of my lids. I'm not using this shadow wet. If I was to use it wet, it would be very metallic, very high shine, and that would defeat the purpose of a soft glam. When you use a metallic shadow dry, the little specks of glitters really come through and it's quite subtle, and that's what I really want for this soft glam look. I'm also taking that in towards my inner corners to highlight that area, as well onto my brow bone to highlight. Then I am taking Amuse Me. This is the pressed glitter, so just a warning to be careful if you are going to be playing with glitter around your eyes. I'm going to take this on a brush and just gently pat that on top of On a Wing and kind of spread it out. I just want like little specks of glitters to peek through. When you tilt your head, you will see those little glitters come through. I don't want it to be too harsh, but I am going to take quite a lot of it and put that onto my lower lash line right at the inner corner and really pack on that glitter there. This is a technique that I see done mostly like in Asia and in Korea. They really like their glitter, especially on their lower lash. I actually think it looks really pretty. It kind of ties in the little sparkles that we place on our top lid. For my eyeliner today, I just took the ColourPop BFF liquid liner in the shade Grande to line my eyes, and then I took a brown eyeshadow to smudge out and smoke out the eyeliner so it's a little bit more diffused and more subtle for this soft glam eye look. I also took the faux lashes from ColourPop from this collection in the style Shorty, and I applied these to my eyes. And to just finish off the look, I quickly took the creme gel liner from the collection in the shade Charmer and I used that to tightline my bottom waterline just at the outer third. Alright you guys, so this is the second look completed. For my final lip pairing, I decided to go with the Ultra Blotted Lip in the shade Tattletale. I just thought, again, very monochromatic with the little subtle pinks in the eye look. But I really do hope you guys enjoyed this second look. It's very glam, but very soft and subtle at the same time. I think this eye technique really complements my eye shape and it's just a look that I definitely would wear in my day-to-day life. I really liked how it turned out. Super girly. Super fun, love it. So I hope you guys enjoyed it as well. So we are now moving into the third look. I am going to be starting off with the shade Boo Bird, and this is going to be our transition shadow. I'm just going to work that straight into my crease using windshield wiping motions, and as you can see, I am bringing this like literally up to my brow bone. I want this to like peek through underneath the cut crease that we're going to create later on, so making sure you are blending that up towards your brow bone. I then move on to the shade Heron Chic, and I am going to pretty much pack this on my lid space, and then I'll blend it up towards my crease area. I'm unsure if it's this shade or if it's because I'm layering it on top of another matte that it does look a little bit patchy, but because we are creating a half cut crease, like we're going to be cutting out the shadow anyway, it doesn't really affect it too much, but it was a little bit hard to work with that patchiness. Then I am taking the shade Plumage. I'm pretty much doing exactly the same thing. I'm actually gonna work it in the outer third of my eyes first and then bring it in towards the inner part of my eyes. But honestly, all in all, it's just going all over my lid space at this point. Every time I do have cut creases, I do start with my eyes first. So I do go a bit more heavy-handed just to get like the pigmentation there, and I can always clean up afterwards, which you guys will obviously see right after this. So I am now taking my P. Louise eyeshadow base, and I'm gonna use this to cut out my cut crease. You can always use a concealer if you don't have the space. It's just what I like to use. But pretty much I will apply the base towards the inner part of my lids. I'll bring that up towards my crease and kind of just following the natural line of the way my eye shape is curved. And that's how I like to carve out my cut crease. But then I'll also take a very thin paintbrush and I'll just literally drag it along my crease line to make that very sharp and really, really cut out that crease. So that's just the way I do it. I know other people have different techniques of how they like to cut their crease, but this is just how I have been doing it for the past year or so. I'm now going to take the shade Nevermore, and I am going to be using this shadow wet. I'm going to place that right on top of that P. Louise base. This is a beautiful like pink with a lot of gold reflex in it, and it's super, super pretty. I think it complements the purpley pink eyeshadows really, really well. But I'm also going to take the shade Ariel. This is a super shock shadow, and I'm just going to place that right on top of Nevermore. It's similar to the first look, what we did, how we placed like the super shock shadow on top of Nevermore, but this time Ariel's a little bit more peachy, more champagne, so it's really gonna tie in with Nevermore while still enhancing those gold reflex. I then just took my eyeliner, just a black eyeliner, to line my eyes and also give myself a wing, because this look is very dramatic, very glam. I think a wing is just necessary. Going back into the shade Heron Chic, I'm going to use this all over my bottom lash line, just going to smoke it out right from the outer corner to the inner corner. And to finish off the look, I am taking the creme gel liner in the shade Charmer, and I'm going to use that to tightline my entire bottom waterline. So this, you guys, is the first look completed. For my final lip pairing, I went with the ultra glossy lip in the shade Wild Nested. I love a good gloss with a half cut crease. That's just like a signature combo for me, I feel. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this half cut crease. I really liked how this cut crease turned out. Actually, I feel like my cut creases are like kind of the same size, because with my uneven eyes, sometimes one cut crease is a bit bigger than the other. But I feel like this time I got it kind of right. I took my time today as well, and I just really like the color combination and how everything turned out. So I hope you guys enjoyed this final look as well. Alright you guys, so that is going to conclude today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Again, I am so sorry for the delay on this video. Like, I don't think I've ever been this late for a ColourPop review. Anyway, I'm sorry, I don't even think this video is worth the wait, but I hope you guys enjoyed the video anyway. If it's not too late, if you could give it a thumbs up, I would appreciate it so much if you did. Let me know your thoughts down below. Did you guys already purchase this collection? Are you going to after watching this? What do you guys think? What are highlights from this collection? In your opinion, I would love to know down below in the comments. I just love chatting with you guys, so please leave your comments down below. Just if you want to say hi, I'll say hi back. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please subscribe if you haven't already. I love you guys, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.